Well, I was about to start filming this video, and now Harlow has awoken from her nap, and I don't know where her dad is right now, so let me go grab her. Dad took baby, so oh, they're back. No, no. You can both come say hi. Hello, little one. Look at you. Who's that? Hello, friends. Welcome to my very messy living room. I still have no childcare help, really, so yeah, it is what it is. I'm sure a lot of you can relate to this mess back here, so I wasn't even gonna try and clean it up. I thought we would do a 6-month/7-month update. She's not 7 months yet, but she will be very soon on the 22nd of this month. So I thought I would just kind of include that all in one, but I'm gonna give you guys a little update on Harlow. And part of the reason why I really wanted to stick to a schedule of doing updates and I haven't been the best at it is because I really want Harlow to be able to look back on these videos, and I want to be able to look back on these videos. So I highly recommend doing a video diary for yourself and your children, even if you don't have a YouTube channel, or maybe you could have a YouTube channel and keep it private. I think you can, yeah, you can keep videos private. So that's one way to do it, or you can just store the video somewhere. But anyways, I just like love looking back on old DVDs of myself and my siblings when we were younger. And so anyways, just an idea I thought I'd throw out there. I wanted to kind of make all of the normal disclosures you hear when people make these videos, but literally, sorry, that's the cat door. Like, every baby develops at a completely different rate. So don't feel like things you hear in this video, your baby is like too far behind, because babies all are just so different, and moms that have like multiple children know better than even I do that they really do all develop at different paces, and sometimes they're a little more advanced in one area and not another. So don't compare your child and your baby to my baby. You know, it's just they all develop at totally different rates, and some things Harlow is behind on, but I'm not worried about it because we're fostering a good learning environment and a good positive environment, and she's gonna get there at her own pace. So don't worry if like I say something and you're like, oh my gosh, my baby hasn't done that, or like I feel like they're not doing that, like you're fine. But if you want a little more, if you want to set your mind at ease, I guess, don't listen to me, ask all of the moms. I have a Facebook group called The Real Moms Club, and you can join that. I'll leave the link in the description box below. And I slept on my neck wrong last night. It's like killing me, dude. I can't even like look that way. But that group is full of new moms. I don't want to say old moms, but moms that have like seasoned moms. That's that. There we go. Seasoned moms. You're not old. You're seasoned. You're not ancient. You know what you're doing. You can ask questions on there. You can ask about different things. You can post pictures. You can just share like a funny meme, like whatever. Like, the group is there for you. It's non-judgmental. It is there just to be a resource for encouragement, love, laughter, all of that kind of stuff. So if you have any questions about your child, it's your first child maybe, or even your second or whatever, you can post there and feel taken care of and loved, and not be judged. Basically, I think I did the last update at 4 months. A lot has happened. Some of these updates might have been in that video, so sorry if I repeat them. I'm trying to keep it just at the 6 month kind of like, actually a lot's happened recently, so I don't think there'll be any duplicates. But so a giant one for me that has been so amazing and has really just kind of changed things is the fact that Harlow is holding her own bottle. She started to do this and tried to do this like months ago, but now is actively holding her own bottle. Like when she goes down for a nap, she holds her own bottle. When we're in the car yesterday, she was fussing. I knew she was hungry. I leaned behind the seat and kind of showed it to her on the side of her car seat, and she grabbed it. And first she had it like upside down and she was like trying to like suck on the bottom of it, but she figured it out. She, good problem solving, actually, good for her. Flipped it the right way, fed herself her bottle, and that's been great. We are kind of switching around formulas right now because we have been on HIP and Holly from Germany. I'll link you to where I buy those from below as well. But she is spitting up a ton. So it seems like a lot. So I've gathered some information and some opinions from other people, and they think that it's a little overkill. So we're gonna try maybe like a little anti acid reflux formula. And I believe Holly makes one. I just purchased some. So we're gonna be trying that for sure. She is now sleeping on her stomach. I forgot to tell my friend Michelle in Nashville, who was babysitting her while we were out there. We were there for the entire month of November, and we went out and we were like, peace, we're going to dinner. And she texts me, she's like, oh my gosh, she keeps rolling over on her stomach. I keep going in there and turning her over. I'm like, no, stop, don't wake her up. Like, she's good. Like, she is rolling over all by herself now. She's having a little bit of a hard time rolling back over. Like, if she's on her stomach, she keeps getting her arm stuck like outwards like this. And I'm trying to help her out with that one. But she's got a very strong neck. She can sleep on her stomach now. So I'm not worried about any like, you know, suffocating hazards or anything like that. She has been standing super well. She has always actually done this. Like, I feel like from the day that she was even like 2 months old, she was had very strong legs. So now I just kind of hold her hands and like let her like stand there, and she does a lot of bouncing now. She's kind of learned to like bend her knees, which like took us a minute, which was really hard for bending her, like to seat her in seats and things like that, like high chairs and whatnot. Like, she's finally understanding, like, I can bend my knees, like this works. So that's been really great. And she has a really great bouncer that you guys have probably seen me post on my Instagram stories if you follow me there. But she's finally like learned how to like bounce herself in it. And it's like a game changer because now she actually has fun in there. Before, she just kind of like rolled around and like turned around and stuff. But now she's actually using her legs, and something like that's really good for your baby and helping them stand with their own body weight and like helping like balance them, because it really strengthens their leg muscles. So all of those things are super good for your baby. Oh my gosh. So I am about to have a baby with a front tooth, like an upper front tooth. Like, I can't even believe it. She's got two little bottom ones, which she definitely did not have when I did the last update. So she's got two little bottom teeth. And it was really funny. I did a video of her with like these big eyes and big lips, and I'll put it on the screen because it is so funny. Like, her bottom two teeth, it's like one of you said, it's the teeth for me. And I was like, yeah, dude, me too. Like, the teeth look hilarious in this video. But she has an upper, like, her upper freaking tooth is coming. And I can't even believe it. Like, how am I gonna look at her the same with an upper front tooth? Like, I just don't even know. Like, it's so weird. Like, she's gonna look so grown up with front teeth. I don't know. Apparently, like, the teeth coming around like 6 to 9 months, you know, whatever. But like, I'm just still shocked that she's about to have a front. Like, I don't believe that I'm gonna have a baby with front teeth, like upper front. Like, that's I can't even believe it. Okay, moving on. Speaking of standing, neck, and all of that, I have switched from a bumbo, which my baby's fat, chunky thighs do not fit in, unfortunately, to an up seat. The cat is on the counter. She knows she's not supposed to be on the counter. Tipsy? Tipper. We're back. The up seat is supposedly better for their posture. This one has like a tray on it, so I'll use it to help her eat with us when we're doing some baby lead weaning, which I'll talk to you guys about in a second. But I take the tray off and I just set it on the ground and put a bunch of toys around her, and I can do the dishes. She'll just like grab things, and it helps her sit up because she's not fully sitting up right now. Some babies are by this point, some aren't. She is like to the point where she can sit up and balance herself for like a good little bit, but as soon as she starts to kind of move around a little too much, she falls backwards. So I actually used my Butterco breastfeeding pillow to put behind her, and she actually will lean back and hold her bottle and drink her bottle and watch TV or like watch Blippi. Oh my gosh, she's obsessed with freaking Blippi, dude. I was like, who is this creep? But Blippi has some interesting history on the internet if you've ever Googled him. I'm not gonna say it, I'll let you look it up for yourself. This is a kid-friendly video, but yeah, so loves Blippi, but if she can lean back and, you know, listen to music and drink her bottle, watch TV, whatever we've got going on, and it's useful for that, and then also now helping her sit up. But if you're trying to keep them like pretty self-sufficient while you're doing multiple like dishes, chores, like whatever, the upseat is great because you just take that tray off, you let her, she can sit right in it on the ground and just sit upright. So it really helps her with her posture, and it actually I feel like is helping her learn how to like sit up straight. And it's not for a lack of strength in her core, because she has like the strongest core. Like when I tell you, it is hard to change this baby's diapers because she's just lifting her head up and flexing her stomach and straightening her legs. Like she makes it so difficult to change her diaper. It's like another level. Harlow is seeing very long distances. She is loving the cat and the dog. She is loving the cat and the dog. She actually has been petting the dog and the cat very gently. I'm not sure, like I have to like, I hover over her hand because a couple times she grabbed Piper's fur like really hard, kind of like she grabs my hair and my earrings. And she like grabbed it too hard, and Harlow, I mean, Piper did not like that shit. I'm already switching names up and I only have one child. Dear Jesus, help me. So she got a little rough there, so I keep an eye on it. I don't let her touch the reptiles, obviously salmonella. It's a little hard to like sanitize her little baby hands. So, but if you do, there are sanitizing wipes. So, so yeah, she's loving the animals though. Like it is so cute watching her giggle and laugh when the animals come near her. Like Piper will come up and like rest her head on her belly, and the cat will come over. Surprisingly, both of our cats absolutely love Harlow. They always come by and like let her pet them. And this morning it was so cute. She like did like the softest little pets, and I'm, you know, talking to her and saying soft, gentle. She doesn't know what that means, but I just try and talk like in a soft voice. So it's like calming, and like I show her how I pet. I don't like, kids want to imitate you. So I don't know if she's really understanding and putting two and two together, but I'm gonna try, okay? So I'm showing her how to pet the cat super gently, and she actually like was great this morning, and she didn't pull any hair. It was awesome. So as far as nighttime, I know you're all wondering, you probably are if you're a new mom or about to be. She woke up twice last night. She has been randomly waking up. It just started happening at like 11 or 11:30. I think it could be a little bit of pain for the teeth, which I'll talk to you about a couple remedies that have been working for me in a second. And then around like 3:30. So it's random. It'll literally be zero wake ups to two wake ups. And you just never know what you're gonna get. It doesn't seem like anything changes it. Like it doesn't seem like changing the bedtime or activities before bed, or like, it doesn't seem like there's any rhyme or reason is what I'm trying to say. And I wanted to, I'll link you to two things below because I can't remember the exact name, but there are two things I've been using for teething that seem to really work. I have been stocking up on bibs. We go through like, between the spit up and the drool, we go through like 10 bibs a day. Like your girl is doing laundry like all day long. Like I kid you not, like our water bill, I don't even want to know. wash everything on cold though, so it doesn't cost a ton of gas. But so there's a two pack of soothing gel. One's a like a during the day one, and then one is more of like a calming nighttime one. So I've been using that, and that really worked. Like the other day she was crying during her nap, and I could tell that she was just like uncomfortable. Like she didn't want anything, you know? She didn't want a bottle. She didn't want to be soothed. Like she was just in pain. So we try and stay away from Tylenol and Motrin for the most part. Like, we wanna keep it all natural. So these two things I'm telling you about are natural. And then there are these little teething tablets. They're really, really tiny, and you put it under the tongue and they dissolve very quickly. So I did both of those the other night when she, or during the day, it was a nap, I can't remember, but did both of those, put the little gel on there, and she passed out within 5 minutes. So I don't know if it like cools the area to like take away the like painful sensation, but it worked. So I will link those for you in the description box below. She is at a point and a stage where she is grabbing everything, and it's been like this for like a month, I would say, where anything I'm drinking, anything I'm touching, anything that's in front of her, anything we're walking by, like Home Goods, like we were in the glassware section. That was a terrible place for Harlow to be in a carrier. Like, just don't do that to yourself. She grabs everything off the tables, and they learn by putting it in their mouth, right? So she's like putting everything in her mouth. So she can grab everything, she's putting everything in her mouth. So we have to be very vigilant about like what's near her. Not only so she doesn't break things, but so she doesn't put something in her mouth that shouldn't be there. Like a water bottle, for instance, like that little lid can come right off, and it can very quickly become a very scary choking hazard. So you have to be very aware, but it's challenging. Like you have to be on it. And she, yeah, she's fast. She's a fast little sucker. Harlow loves to look at herself in the mirror. She also loves other children and other babies. When I show her books with babies, or there is a friend's child or baby over, she will start giggling when they come near her. Like, my nephew spent Thanksgiving with us, and he would come up and like talk to her and like smile at her. It was like the most pure, precious thing like you've probably ever seen. And she would just start giggling, and it was just like, oh my gosh, my heart's gonna fall out of my butt. This is so cute. And she just loves it. She loves to look at herself in the mirror. Like in the morning, I'll bring her in the bedroom with me, and we have a mirror right next to the bed, because you know, that's how you do things in your marriage, if you know what I mean. So she leans up and she's looking at herself in the mirror, and I'm like, who's that pretty girl? And she just starts laughing, and it's like the cutest thing. I live for it, basically. So the last update I have for you before I go into, I'm gonna share some things that like activities that I do with Harlow and that you can do with your 6 month old if you're kind of like, okay, what do I do now? It's not like they really understand what I'm saying, whatever. So I'll get to that in a second. But lastly, and kind of one of the most excitingly, is that a word? She is on to solids. Not to say that she's not still having formula. Formula is her main source of nutrients. But she has started solid. So we started doing baby lead weaning a couple weeks ago. I did put a video up where she tried her first foods, and we documented the whole first food and baby lead weaning experience. So I'll link you to that in the description box below if you want to check it out. But yeah, she's trying foods. This morning she had some Cheerios, not the Honey Nut Cheerios, but the regular Cheerios. You don't want to feed honey to your baby. But the regular Cheerios, and she had a little bit of avocado and egg. I think the only thing that she actually ate, and this is the only thing I've seen her actually eat, was the Cheerios. Everything else just kind of ends up everywhere, but it's really good for her to be able to touch new textures, experience new things and colors and picking up things. So yeah, that it's been going really well. But of course they say food before one is just for fun. So yeah, we're sticking with the formula for now. I'm gonna go through this pretty quickly because if you're anything like me, you have 1 million things to do and not enough time to do it. So I just put together a list of some different things that I've collected from other videos, from reading, things that I've just come up with to do with Harlow. But I wanted to share some of these with you because I feel like there's certain, like Harlow's kind of going through this stage right now where she's not, most days, there are the exceptions to the rule, and to the, not to the rule, but like to what I'm saying. But typically nowadays, over the past couple weeks, she has not been like content just sitting there with like her toys or her different things. Like she has to be like engaged, and I have to be holding her or talking to her or showing her something. She won't just like sit there and play with something while I do dishes much anymore. However, yesterday, I swear the first day her dad was off from working for 6 days with one day in between, he comes home and she's just like in her bouncer all by herself for like 20 minutes, just fine. Like, we'd walk by every now and then and be like, hey, hey, interact or whatever. Fine. We had her on the floor over here in her up seat playing with stuff. Totally fine for like 15 minutes. Something just went in my eye. And I'm like, this is not how she's been the past 6 days. Let me tell you what. But it was really great. So, kitchen utensils. I found that Harlow loves to play with things that aren't actually toys and play with things that like mommy and daddy play with, like kitchen utensils. So we've been taking kind of like the silicone spatula. She loves to play with that. She loves, like, we have like a whisk, like a plastic whisk, loves it. So find things around the house that like are safe, of course, and don't have little pieces and things, like use your brain. But yeah, she find things around the house and like give it to your baby and see what they think. Cause like it's something new, it's a new texture. It almost feels like they're not supposed to have, like, what I do sometimes is if I'm holding her, I'll put her on the counter in front of me and like let her lean forward and grab it. Like she's like pulled one over on me and I haven't, like she's pulling something off the table she shouldn't be. She loves it. I've taken her out in the garden and let her like touch and feel and smell like basil and the different plants. Obviously you wanna make sure that they're safe and clean your hands afterwards and all of that good stuff. But we don't use pesticides in our garden, FYI. But she likes to like touch the leaves and like she'll reach out and touch it very gently. Like it's just new colors, new textures, new sights, new sounds. She loves going on walks outside or just walking out to the backyard and like looking outside, seeing the birds fly by, the clouds, the moon, like whatever it is. She like loves to just look at new things. So going on a walk in our neighborhood, she like loves it. She doesn't make a peep the whole time. She just is taking it all in. Helping your baby sit up and helping them stand is something that takes a lot of concentration, so it tires them out, but it also builds their muscles and is really good for them in general. And it also helps them learn how to sit up and how to stand. And so you just give them a little bit of guidance and it's super fun. I also, one thing that she loves is if you grab, you have to be careful doing this, obviously you don't wanna dislocate their arms, but if I gently grab her by her arms where they're extended like this and let her stand on my chest, she thinks that is just the funniest thing ever. She likes to kind of slowly be lifted up and I make faces at her. She loves that. Speaking of faces, mirrors, mirror time is like free. It's like, it's super easy. You just walk up to a mirror. She loves to look at herself. She likes to touch it. So make sure you have some Windex. She loves to look at it, look at herself, touch the mirror. She'll look at me in the mirror. And then she'll look at me in person. It's really interesting to watch her like understand it. I feel like she understood like a mirror like pretty quickly. I was really impressed. I was like, this is gonna take her a while to understand that this is like a reflection, but it did not. I love to show her different body parts. So we've got the LOVEVERY kit coming like every 2 or 3 months or something like that. So I got a body parts book and it shows different children, different ethnicities, and it shows like nose, mouth, eyes, hair, feet. And so I'll go through the book with her and I'll point to her nose and her ears and I'll point to my own if she's looking at me. And that's like, she's very interested in looking at babies. Like I was saying, like she loves to look at babies. So that book is totally a hit. Any videos with babies or kids in them, she really likes. Any TV shows like that, she really likes. She really loves watching animal videos. Obviously not the ones where they're like the lions tearing the antelope apart or anything like that. But like funny animal videos, she really loves watching the different animals. So that could be something great if your child seems to be interested in animals. Interactive bath time is something that I find super fun. Like I found these really cool LED light up bath toys for babies and I don't have them yet, but it's on Harlow's Christmas wish list and her grandma is getting them. Thanks, grandma. Well, I should say her great grandma, my grandma is getting them for her. So any like cups and again, think of just stuff around the house that you can put in the bath with them and play with them. Obviously no glass, but LOVEVERY also has these cups that you fill up with water and like they trickle down like this and like they can, they like to, like Harlow loves to watch the water and like grab it and like try to grab it and like reach out and touch it. It's good to put a little water on her face. I like to get her used to that because she goes in the pool. So we'll splash a little bit of water on her face and she'll kind of like have that reaction to like hold her breath, which is good. A little bit of training for the pool before we actually train in the pool, which we need to start that soon actually. But anything in the bath that's fun, measuring cups is a big hit in there. The spatula, again, I take some of her plastic toys in there that, you know, are waterproof. She like loves all of that. Another thing you can do is taking a bath with them. I took a bath with Harlow the other day and I was able to sit in there and interact with her and show her things and show her like my body parts, like my nose, my ears, you know, and so that was really fun. And it's a good like bonding experience. Also skin to skin shower. Dad does those with her all the time. She's very like slimy in the shower, slippery. I'm afraid to drop her. So I've only done it once, but Nick is super strong and has bigger arms and is just bigger in general. So he will take a shower with her and it's just so cute. She's got a smile plastered on her face like the entire time. The bouncer is a really great, the doorway bouncer, I'll link you to the one that I have below. That's been super great. I also will say that in the baby led weaning video that I did, she had a really cool like clip-on like chair that we can put at the islands at our house. So if you have like a bar top or like an island or whatever in your house, that's a really cool way to have them be able to sit with you. And another one that I was gonna talk about is eating with your baby, showing them how you put the food in your mouth, and they want to watch you. They want to watch everything that you're doing. They're just like soaking it in. So even telling them like the colors of the things that are on your plate. And even when you're starting to baby led wean, you can give them food too of their own. But even if they're not eating yet, they just put some toys in front of them and eat with them and make that like, you know, I don't know if you want to make that part of your family thing, but I always think it's a great idea to eat as a family, talk about your day. Like I'm a big fan of that. So that's kind of what I'm starting to create, is that family dynamic of eating together. So I highly recommend that as well. If your baby's a little younger too, she's not super into this anymore, but she was so into this. So if you have like a 1-month-old, a 2-month-old, draw some pictures with a Sharpie on like white paper. And if you can put that, like if they're laying on their back, if you can somehow like stick it to something, like maybe the play gym, they like love to look at those like really contrasting images. So what I did is I made a few of those and put them above where I change her, because there's a cabinet right above. She would sit there and stare at those for like 5 minutes while I like dealt with what was going on down there. You know, those breast milk diapers, holy heck. Those were out of control. So she used to love to do that. She really doesn't look at it anymore now, but she did in the beginning and it really kept her attention. I also would make those and put them on the back of the headrest in the car, so that when she was in her car seat, she'd be looking at not just a seat, a black seat, and not be able to see anything else, but I would tape the picture on there. So you can put a mirror there as well for her to see herself. Obviously you probably have a mirror so that you can see her too. But anyways, that kind of wraps up our milestones and update video. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. The cat is like trying to get out of the window over here. What is going on?
What are you doing?
Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this one and we will see you in the next video. I'm thinking about doing, I still need to do my breastfeeding video, and then I also wanted to talk to you guys about some of the fourth trimester and like newborn like through 6 month items that like I loved and that I didn't love. So I think that would be a good one. I think my list is almost fully complete. So if you want to see that, give this video a thumbs up. It really helps my channel out, and we will see you in the next video. Bye guys.
Little Harlow, you want to say hi to everybody? Say hi. Hi, 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 hi.
You want this bottle? You want to show everybody how you hold it all by yourself?
Yeah.
She can like do this one-handed too. She'll like look everywhere.
You have got this down, girl.
Yes, you do. You're such a big girl. She's finally growing a little bit more hair.
Yummy. Is that good? I want to kiss you, but I got lipstick on. I can't do it. That's why I don't like to wear lipstick or lip gloss. I want to kiss your little face.